This week, we wanted to show you how to make a great Sichuanese dish from Chongqing, Suancaiyu. While this dish might not be much of a looker, it's super popular these days here in China. It's a riff off the classic shuizhou fish, but made with pickled veg and fish soup. So, to get started with Suancai fish, you'll need fish. This was a smallmouth bass. You'd preferably want something freshwater, but basically any sort of white, flaky fish would be okay. You want it filleted, at least 300 grams worth of meat. Ideally, filleted a bit better than this. We got this done at our local market, and Steph was, like, complaining the whole time about it. But regardless, take the fish and place it in a bit of water. Add in 3 tablespoons liaojiu, a.k.a. Shaoxing wine. Let it soak for about 5 minutes and give it a quick rinse. This soak will draw out the blood and remove the unwanted fishy smell. Now grab your fillets and slice them at a real shallow angle, like almost horizontally, to get nice thin pieces. You want the widest pieces you can muster, and something like this is perfect. Once you've worked through the fish, transfer over to a bowl and marinate with a half teaspoon salt, a tablespoon of cornstarch, a teaspoon white pepper powder, and 1 egg white. Mix thoroughly and set that aside. Now, suancaiyu was invented pretty recently, either the 80s or the 90s, so there's a few different variations. We're doing the type that focuses on having a drinkable soup. So over medium-low heat, toss in the fish bones and head to fry. Fry for about 10 minutes until you can see a touch of browning, then add in 2 liters of hot, boiled water. Toss in a slice of ginger, bring to a boil, cover, and lightly boil over medium-high heat for 30 minutes to get a quick Chinese-style fish stock. Half hour later, remove the fish and save the soup. We'll be adding that back in later on. And now for the titular ingredient, suancai. This is 400 grams of a Sichuanese sort of pickle that's made from mustard greens. There's no real sub for this, but, you know, while it'd be super inauthentic, I don't think doing this with sauerkraut or kimchi would taste bad or anything. We'll also be cooking this with 50 grams pickled ginger, and if you can't find this sort, just sub with fresh ginger, and 50 grams pickled yeshanjiao chilies, and tossing in pickled jalapenos instead would be just fine. Add some water to your pickles, and let it sit for 5 minutes to get out a bit of the salinity. Now take the suancai, squeeze the water out, cut into roughly 1 centimeter slices, do the same with the ginger and the chilies. And for some aromatics, mince up 1 inch of fresh ginger, 2 cloves of garlic, and we are ready to fry. So over medium-high heat, toss in about 1 tablespoon of lard or your oil of choice. Once that's melted down, add in the minced garlic and the ginger, fry for about 30 seconds till fragrant, then go in with the suancai. Fry that for about 3 minutes or so until the suancai wilts and dries out a bit, then add in the pickled ginger and the chilies. Fry for about 30 seconds, then pour 1 tablespoon liaojiu wine over the spatula and around the sides of the wok. Fry for another 30 seconds, then add back your quick fish stock. Cover and let it simmer for 3 minutes. Now, you don't want this to go on too long. What you're looking for is this sort of yellowish hue. At this point, season with 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/2 tablespoon of sugar, an optional small sprinkle of MSG, and 1 tablespoon of white vinegar. Now taste, adding a bit more seasoning or water if need be, but this was good for us. So move everything over to a serving bowl, then bring your liquid up to a boil and down right below a simmer. Think like egg poaching temperature. Now add in the fish and poach for about 2 minutes. You don't want to fiddle around with this too much, but you can periodically gently push the fish back and forth to make sure that it's cooked evenly. Once the fish is no longer pink, transfer on top of the serving bowl. Bring the soup back up to a boil, then pour it all over everything. And for a bit of taste and look, sprinkle on about 4 sliced scallions and 3 minced garlic cloves. We're almost done here. We'll just top this off with some chilies and Sichuan peppercorns. Get about 3 tablespoons of oil. Peanuts fine, but preferably Sichuan caizhou or Indian mustard seed oil, up till it's basically starting to smoke. Add in 1 tablespoon of Sichuan peppercorns and 10 grams of sliced deseeded chilies, immediately moving off the heat and pouring it over the suancaiyu. Optionally spread things around to make everything all pretty, and the suancaiyu is done.
So you can actually turn this into a hot pot. What you can do is use about 3 liters of water and make a little bit more stock. And after finish eating the fish, and you can just dip meat or vegetables or noodles in, whatever you like. So check out the other link in the description box for detailed recipe. A big thank you for everyone that's supporting us on Patreon. And of course, subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos.